Good morning. Good to see all of you here this morning on this beautiful, beautiful day. As I was telling people, I'm leaving this afternoon for Arizona to get out of this terrible winter that we've been having, away from the 70 degrees to where it's 80. Special welcome if there are any visitors who are with us. Glad you could join us for our service this morning. I am Pastor Dwayne Eggebauer, a retired pastor that moved out here a year and a half ago. I joined our Saviors and fill in wherever I need it. Just one brief announcement before we begin our ringing of the bells and meditative musical moment, and that is Peg is going to be passing around a sign-up sheet for those who would like to purchase flowers for the Easter service. Let's take a minute to prepare ourselves for worship.
To Jesus I surrender, all to Him I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him. In His presence daily live. surrender all to Jesus. I surrender humbly at his feet. I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now, and I surrender all. Oh, I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. I surrender.
We turn to our opening dialogue. As we listen to Jesus' story of the prodigal son and respond to it as our own story, we will catch a message for our Lenten journey. Praising God will be the outcome. We sing the first four verses of All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. Please rise as we continue with the celebrating. As always, we begin our worship.
In the name of the Father, who reaches out to us.
In the name of the Son, who is always ready to forgive us.
In the name of the Holy Spirit, who guides us on our Lenten journey.
Therefore, we praise him, for he is rich in mercy and abounds in steadfast love. We pause now to confess our sins. O Lord, as we take a good look at the way we live, we see the blunders that we make, the bluntness of our remarks, the buildup of our egos. We have failed. We cringe at what we have done. We recognize our foolishness. We cry aloud and seek your mercy. Lord, forgive. We hear you say to the children of Israel and to us, I will forgive your wickedness and we will remember your sins no more. As far as the east is from the west, so the Lord has removed your transgressions. God is love, and his love prompted him to send his son Jesus to redeem, forgive, and restore you. We are a Lenten people.
And Lord, have mercy, is our cry.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share God's peace with those around you. God's peace be with you. God's peace. Thank you. God's peace with you. God's peace with you. God's peace with you. Oh, good. Good. No, I was getting ready to go. God's peace be with you. God's peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Let us pray. God of compassion, you welcome the wayward and you embrace us all with your mercy. Help us always to praise you for your forgiveness and love which we receive at your table. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I'll invite the children to come forward for the children's message while we sing Jesus Loves Me. This is unusual. We have almost more girls than boys. What happened to all the boys?
I don't know.
Good to see all of you here this morning. Our theme for worship this morning is praise. And do you know what praise means? It's a little bit different than giving thanks. When you give thanks, you thank God for or others for something they specifically have done. So when you get a present, you say, thank you. When you've had a good meal, you say, thank you for the great meal. So there's something personally involved. When we praise, it's actually praising God for what God has done. So today we might praise God for the beautiful weather that he's provided. And there's different ways that we can praise God. So can you think this morning, what are some ways that we can praise God? Any idea? Well, let me give you some suggestions. One way we could praise God is by singing, right? And the last Sunday of the month, they have what's called a praise team that leads worship. And so they sing their songs of praise. It's a way to praise God. We can praise God while we pray. So when we pray, we can say, praise you, God, for all that you have provided for us. We're praising God when we pray. What did you hear play at the beginning of the service?
Music.
What kind of music?
Flute.
You think you can praise God with the flute? You know, throughout the Bible, we hear people praising God with harps, string instruments. So we heard praising God with the piano, with the flute. You know, in one other way that sometimes we don't think of, but you know, in the morning sometimes when I sit in the hot tub, not so much here because there doesn't seem to be as many, but in my previous place, I would always hear the birds singing. Do you think the birds praise God?
Probably.
I think animals have a way of praising God too, so there's many, many ways that we can praise God. And so today we look at the theme of praising God for all that God has done. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, we praise you because you are wonderful and have prepared and have given us so many things. Amen. All right, thanks for coming up. And you got Tootsie Rolls. As I said it last week, for those who was here, that's my wife's favorite candy, so I had to give her one. Wasn't that nice of me? You think she'll praise me? Whoops. All right. Let us sing the gospel acclamation. If you need the music, it's found on page 142. That's the small number in the front of your hymnal.
First scripture today is from Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. This poor soul cried and was heard by the Lord and was saved from every trouble. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you his holy ones. For those who fear him have no want. The young lions suffer want and hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. The word of the Lord. Our gospel reading is from Romans chapter 5. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I was asked to share a little of my story this morning. You see, I'm a father of two sons. I loved both of those sons. And I remember as they were growing up, we would celebrate their birthday every year. And what a fun time that was. The aunts and uncles would come over, my brothers and sisters, their children, my boys, cousins. Oh, they'd have full fun playing. It was a great, great time. We were a family that loved to celebrate. And I remember one of the greatest times of the year was Passover. How we looked forward to Passover every year. All of the relatives would come, and we'd have a time of feasting to celebrate. You know, Passover, celebrating that wonderful event in our history where God set us free from bondage. You know, my people were slaves in Egypt, and God set us free from being in Egypt, led us to the wilderness, to the promised land. And so each year we would gather on that Passover and celebrate that great thing. We would sing together those Passover psalms, wonderful psalms of praise to God, and we would share that wonderful Passover meal. You know, roast lamb. You know, every year we would get into a discussion. Was this roast lamb better than last year? Oh, how we looked forward to that. And the unleavened bread. Oh, the smell of that freshly made unleavened bread permeating the house along with that roast lamb. Oh, it smells so good. But I have to admit, my favorite was the harissat. The harissat was a mixture of apples and walnuts, honey, cinnamon, and wine. It was bush that reminded us of the mortar that our forebears had to make while they were slaves in Egypt. But the sweet taste reminded us of that land flowing with milk and honey, abundant fruit, wonderful grapes, made it a great wine. And of course, Passover, we always have to bring out the best wine, not the ordinary wine, but the best wine, because during the meal, we would drink glass after glass after glass of wine. Like I said, it was a great, great time. Enjoyed it every year, looked forward to it. A great gathering, a great celebration, a great time to praise God for all that God had done. Oh, but then life changed. If I remember back, I believe it was shortly after Passover, where my youngest son came and said, actually demanded, that I would give him his share of the inheritance. You know, that younger son was, still is, a free-spirited type of boy. He would like to push me as far as he could to do his own thing. And you could see the wanderlust in his eyes, how he wanted to do something more than just tend the flock. I could have refused. His demand was unheard of. He literally was saying to me, I wish you were dead. An ungrateful, disobedient son. I should have punished him. But what would it have done? It just would have made him more angry, and he probably would have left anyway. So what is a father to do? I gave him his third. And to be fair, I gave my older son his two-thirds of the inheritance. And sure enough, the next day he packed up and left. It broke my heart. Because I had no idea where did he go off to? He told us nothing. Was he in Jerusalem? Did he go to the coast? Did he take off for a foreign country, to Damascus or to Egypt? Where was he? And for over 2 years, I looked almost every day. I looked down that road, hoping that maybe he would return. Just maybe he would come home. Because I loved my son. Even though he was disobedient, even though he had left me brokenhearted, I still loved him. He was my son. And I wanted him back with the family. Oh, and I remember those Passover celebrations. Well, I didn't feel like celebrating. I didn't even feel like drinking wine. My heart was broken. And even though the rest of the family had a good time, I couldn't. It was difficult, very difficult, when we sang those hymns of praise to even feel like praising God, because I felt God had somehow left me down, taken my son away from me, and would he ever return? And then one day it happened. I looked out and I saw this lone figure coming down the road, and I thought to myself, could it be? No, it couldn't. And yet it came closer, and I looked, and sure enough, I could tell it was my son. And so I ran out quickly. I lifted up my robe, and I ran as fast as I could because I wanted to welcome my son back, to tell him how glad I was to see him. But more important, I wanted to protect his life, because as a disobedient son, he could have been put to death. His older brother could have went out and had a legal right to kill him. My brothers could have went out and done the same thing to him. And I wanted to protect his life. His head was downtrodden. I could tell that he was in terrible shape, skinny as a rat. And as I hugged him and kissed him, you could feel the tension in his arms. And finally, with tears in his eyes, he said, Father, he didn't even want to call me father. He says, I don't deserve to come back as a son. Can you take me back as a slave, as a servant? And I said, nonsense. You are my son. I love you. And then I took off this precious ring that I had got from my father, an inheritance, and I put it on his finger, and I said, here, this ring was your grandfather's. It's now yours. You're still part of the family. And then I called my servants over, and I said, servants, come, put on some water, get him cleaned up, put some new clothes on him, put sandals on his feet, and then go kill that fatted calf. We're going to celebrate tonight. Praise God, our son is back. My son is back. He was gone. He was lost. He's been back. He's found. Let's have a party. Let's celebrate. What a day that was. I couldn't help but open my scripture and read those hymns of praise to God and how meaningful they were, that God does bring back the lost, that we can celebrate because God saves us from our troubles. Oh, what a great feast it was. The neighbors came, some of the relatives came at short notice, and we were having a great time. The best wine was brought out, and we were celebrating. Oh, yeah, but somebody was missing, my older son. So I went out, tried to find him, and sure enough, there he was. He was madder than hell. Said, what are you doing welcoming back this son of yours? He wouldn't even call him his brother. And then he made these false accusations about how he had spent all his money on prostitutes, which wasn't true. Then he even accused me of not even giving him a goat. I said, son, I gave you 2/3 of my inheritance. What do you mean I didn't even give you a goat? I explained to him that he was always with me. I always loved him. And that we had to celebrate because his brother had come back. Well, I'll let you to decide if my older son came into the party or not. But I have to admit, that was a great day of celebrating. Celebrating and praising God because God had answered my prayers. God had brought my son back. Oh, what a wonderful praise. You know, it kind of reminded me of the Passover, because the Passover is a great celebration also of God freeing us, saving us, bringing us home to our country, our promised land. You know, someone told me that you are also going to have a celebration this morning, a celebration that goes back to a person you call Jesus, who when he was celebrating that Passover meal, singing those hymns of praise, sharing that wine with his disciples, took from that table that unleavened bread and gave it a new meaning, and took from that cup, from that table, a cup of wine, and again also gave it a new meaning. And I believe you call Jesus that Passover lamb, the one who died, so that we can celebrate the love that God has for us, celebrate the forgiveness. just as I forgave my son and welcomed him back, so also our God is a forgiving God who welcomes us back into the fold. What a great message that is. A great time to gather, to drink wine, to eat bread, to remember God's love, to remember God's forgiveness, and to praise God for all the blessings that God has bestowed upon us. So I hope you have a great time of celebrating and remembering that our God is a God worthy of our praise. Would you please rise as we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The prayer response this morning is, "Your mercy is great." Hearing the call to return to the Lord, let us join the whole people of God in prayer for all who cry out in pain and in hope. For campus ministries, we give you thanks, eternal Lord. Equip the students, staff, and ministers to share your steadfast love with their university community and all whom they meet. Hear us, O God. For polluted oceans and rivers, we seek your healing creativity, Lord. Restore the homes of mantis and sea turtles. Teach us to love the earth as you do. Hear us, O God. For conflicts between political parties, we ask for your discernment and wisdom, merciful Lord. Enable citizens and elected officials to listen to one another and to work together for your justice. Hear us, O God. For the unemployed, the working poor, and all who struggle to make ends meet, we pray for your provisions, gracious Lord. Break down systems that shame and hold all in the truth that they are your children. Hear us, O God. For all who engage in the disciplines of Lent, we seek your strength and grace. Loving Lord, even as we rest in your mercy, create a new heart within us. Hear us, O God. For the healing and health of those ill or hospitalized and their caregivers, including Don, Shana, Roger, Bernie, Chuck, Don, Bill, Ralph and Lois, Brandon, Steve, Peg, Steve, Matt, and Kevin, and for the family of Faye Butler, hear us, O God. To you, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your boundless mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. You may be seated while the prayers are being received, while the offering is being received, sorry.
Via della Rosa in Jerusalem that day. The soldiers tried to clear the narrow way, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating, there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via della Rosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via della Rosa, all the way to Calvary. Por la Via della Rosa, triste día en Jerusalén, los soldados le brían paso a Jesús. Mas la gente se sacaba para ver a qui lavaba qui a cruz. Por la Via della Rosa, que es la via del dolor, como fea vino Cristo, Rey Señor. Fue a quien quiso ir por su mi amor, por ti, por mí. la via della rosa al calvario morì. The blood that would cleanse the souls of all men made its way to the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via della Rosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via della Rosa, all the way to Calvary.
Please rise as we sing our offertory. Praise to you, O Lord, as one who rejoices when sinners repent. Acclaim us as your very own because of your mercy and grace. Send your word to enlighten our darkness with the light of Christ. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink ye all of it. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Just a reminder, I'm not sure if there's visitors or not, but here at Our Savior's, our table is open to all who believe that the bread and wine is Jesus' body and blood, given and shed for the forgiveness of their sins. So we do practice open communion. There is grape juice in the center, the light color, and wine is the dark color. Okay. Just follow along after her. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood strengthen and preserve you unto eternal life. Go in peace. Amen. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood strengthen and preserve you unto eternal life. Go in peace. Amen.
According to thy gracious word, with great humility, this will I do, my dying Lord, I will remember thee. Thy body broken for my sake, my bread from heaven shall be, and with thy cup I take and drink, and thus remember thee. When to the cross I turn my eyes and rest on Calvary, O Lamb of God, my sacrifice, I must remember thee. According to thy gracious word, with great humility, this will I do, my dying Lord, I will remember thee. This will I do, my dying Lord, I will remember thee.
Christ given for you. Jesus Christ, in his precious blood, strengthen and preserve you unto eternal life. Go in peace. Amen. Body of Christ, given for you. This is the body of Christ, given for you. The blood of Christ, shed for you. This is the blood of Christ, shed for you. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, in his precious blood, strengthen and preserve us unto eternal life. Go in peace. Let us pray. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. All right. I was asked to highlight one announcement, and that's Christmas. Easter is coming by the end of the month, and there is a basket in the back to take your donations for the purchase of Easter candy for the Easter egg hunt that our Savior's sponsors for the community each year. So please do that following service. I believe that'll be up for the next couple of weeks, right?
Next week
will be last week? Okay. And next week, Pastor
Arlie
Fadness will be here. So, got another great pastor to come and hear preach. Any other announcements? Yes. Oh, you're selling again.
Yeah.
Support this young man.
Yeah, I'm still selling coupon books for my trip to Germany this summer. This may be the last week I'm selling them. Not completely sure, but I'm going to say it is.
All right. You got Peg?
Which is right?
I had called Peg first.
Go ahead.
Oh, the president goes first? All right. Go ahead, President.
A little more on the moving date. This coming Saturday, some of us are getting together to help move Pastor Deb. We're going to plan on meeting here at Church Parking Lot at 8 o'clock Saturday morning to be down. Just start out moving at the bicycle storage facility.
Probably the shortest you've ever had to move a pastor, huh?
Yeah.
All right, Peg.
As you see, there's many announcements on here today. We did make the list around. We do need more people to sign up this month for Care and Serve. There's different things that we need. There's a list back there. Because I have difficulty going downstairs, I'd prefer if you put your name on this list up here. Mainly, we need people for both services for Easter. So please take a look. If you have any questions, you can give Emily a call or myself. And we need to get this filled. Also, we have some distinguished people in our presence today. Dan and Shelley, would you stand up, please? Congratulations go to Dan and Shelley and Diane Bishop for being awarded the
Volunteer of the Year.
Of the Year Award for Hermosa. They certainly do. And for those who went to Shannon Harris's benefit last Saturday, at the end of the benefit, she and Waylon decided that was the most appropriate time to get married.
verses. Wilson, just two verses of the last two.
Okay, just make that announcement.
You can cut page to the second verse, right? Or you just say, change the same verse to verses.
We talk about basic life skills that are a good thing for everybody to have. But this particular program is just for those with a chronic condition, whatever that might be. So we talk about healthy eating, exercise, managing your medications, even how to communicate with family and the medical professionals about your condition. So it's real practical help just to help manage your life better. So tomorrow night is a preview. There's no obligation. If you come tomorrow night and don't think that can be a program that can help you, there's no obligation to join. We do ask a $10 donation. That is to cover materials, because in the workshops you get a book and a CD of relaxation, music and other imagery techniques. But if you can't pay the $10 or don't want to pay the $10, that's perfectly fine. Nobody is turned away. This is a statewide program, SDS Extension. Department of Social Services and Department of Health are the overall managers and leaders of this in our state. Regional Health is a partner. Sanford and Avera are partners, as are about 20 other organizations across the state. So this is a good program. We want to bring it to the community for the benefit of our community members. So please talk to me or come tomorrow night to get a preview.
Thanks. But there's no cost tomorrow night.
No.
And I want to say, right as Margie had put up the pamphlet out there on the bulletin board, I had gone to one of my doctors, and he started telling me about this program. And I thought, I've heard about this. So I've had a couple of my doctors recommend that I attended.
Okay. Anything else? Let's conclude with the benediction, and then we will sing only the first two verses of Guide Me, Ever Great Redeemer, because we have gone over, and anxious to have coffee. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself, the God our Father, who loved us and gave eternal comfort and good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish them in every good work and word. Amen. Guide Me, Ever Great Redeemer, first two verses. Just a note, as I mentioned, coffee and goodies are going to be served downstairs, and I have been at so many churches where I've been a visitor, and no one has said, you visitors are welcome, and so I don't go. And so if there are any visitors here this morning, you're welcome to join us for coffee and goodies downstairs. Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.